It's that guy. It's, you know, that guy. Trunks. New boss stage or something. Of course, the purple eye meme. They're all evil. Who's that guy? Two more playable characters. We all know them. The Dragon Warrior guy, I think. You might as well put Goku in it. You might as well put Goku in it already. They all look like the same character. People like Dragon Warrior are having a field day right now. Yes, they're really hammering that in this year. Summer, that's pretty close. A lot of games, they don't do the close. It's always next year. Monsters to ride. Oh, that's the game. Past worlds. Okay. It's like taking it back to retro land. The echoes of an elusive age. Complete the story.
Hello everyone, I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi from Nintendo. In this Nintendo Direct for E3 2019, we'll showcase a variety of games, many of them coming soon. But before we dig into the next game, there is someone I'd like to introduce first.
Reggie. Oh.
What? What are you doing here?
Wait a minute. There's been a bit of a mix-up. You're not the right Bowser. Sorry, but I'm the right Bowser for this presentation.
Oh, God. No, let it be Bowser, though.
Not this way.
No. This way.
Bye-bye.
Man, they made Bowser. They made Bowser a joke.
Are you related?
No, but we get that a lot.
Wow.
Well, let's get back to it. Please, take it away.
No.
Hi, everyone. I'm Doug Bowser from Nintendo of America, and I'm thrilled to join you for today's Nintendo Direct. This is our chance to show the world we have games for every type of player on Nintendo Switch. Whether you love action, RPGs, or you're just looking for something new, we've got you covered.
Okay, so let's get a look at one of those games by taking a tour of Luigi's Mansion 3.
Wait, they had a Luigi's Mansion 2? When did that happen?
Hello? Mario.
Oh, God.
Luigi's invited to a gorgeous hotel with Mario,
that's just the remastered.
And the others. Oh, lucky him.
It is basically like the same thing every time.
Luigi's Mansion.
But better graphics.
3. This hotel is much more than meets the eye. For not long after Luigi arrives, things take a dark turn. We begin our tour by taking in some sights and sounds. You may never leave. You want to leave. The other guests certainly don't plan to move on. They're ghosts, after all, and they're rather aggressive. Simply scare them with the strobe bulb, then suck them up. Luigi's new Poltergust G00 has the powerful suction capabilities required, and other new features as well. First, the slam. While trapping a ghost, slam it on the ground to inflict some damage. It helps to get other ghosts in on the action. Next, the suction shot.
Find the plunger
to attach it to something, then pull the string and you can destroy furniture.
I mean, I don't have the Switch, so I don't really care about this too much. I might get it one day. But I don't see myself getting it.
Ghosts may feel inclined to gang up on you.
I don't see it.
In such situations, a burst should do you. The powerful air pressure released will blow away ghosts, and it's perfect for when you need a little air. We simply can't overlook the latest invention from Professor Egad, namely Gooigi. Change between Luigi and Gooigi to use both their skills. Gooigi can do everything from slipping through metal fences to walking on spikes. Indeed, there are obstacles too great for Luigi to handle on his own. And if you pass a Joy-Con controller to a friend, he makes for a great co-op partner. But proceed with caution. Gooigi and water definitely don't mix. Now, please direct your attention to the Scare Scraper. Spooky? Sure. Yet it also
co-op? You got co-op in this game? Just put Mario in the game. Forget about... Why does Mario always have to be lost? That's ridiculous. Don't be ridiculous. Are you kidding me? Just woke up. What's up, Laid Dark Slayer? Voice chat. Why? Who are you? I don't know exactly who you are. I don't trust like that. Wait, who are you?
Many traps and mischievous ghosts lurk within.
That's hard. Oh, okay. Join a voice call and I'll drag you in. Yeah. I can't add you unless you're dragged in. Unless you're in a call somewhere. Unless you're in a room. I can't get you in. I know you and Harz probably use Xbox. This is the big leagues Discord,
so
okay?
Luigi's Mansion 3, the latest game in a series that I personally love. And we can look forward to seeing some of the new gameplay elements that await in this strange hotel as we dive deeper into this title on Nintendo Treehouse live at E3 2019. We'll be streaming content, some you've never seen before, right from the show floor, including live gameplay of Super Mario Maker 2. And on day 3, our Treehouse staff will get their hands on some promising indie games that are new to Nintendo Switch.
All right, Laid, what do you think about
Nintendo
this?
Direct, keep an eye out for this icon to learn what other games will appear on Nintendo Treehouse live at E3 2019. You won't want to miss it. Or this. Have a look.
Okay, what did I miss?
Everything. You missed everything. They already. It's over. Oh, God, what is this trash?
So what I heard so far was Monster Hunter in Smash. Dragon Quest in Smash.
Oh, yeah. That wasn't done already? Do you have a Switch?
Yeah, I have a Switch. Love Switch.
Of course.
I just haven't turned on Smash in like a good bit.
Oh, really? Interesting.
Is this another Dragon Quest game?
They're really hammering in that Dragon Quest.
Bye bye. Have you played Dragon Quest before?
A little bit. I dabbled in Dragon Quest.
I'm halfway done with the latest one.
Oh yeah, I was gonna get that one. But I just didn't make the jump.
The jump, Yugi. The jump.
Yugi.
I just woke up just in like, wait, Dragon Quest? What?
Oh.
I just got treated out to me. I'm like, I hate you guys. You guys woke me up for this. Now I have to watch this.
Who woke you up?
Bunch of my friends.
Oh.
On Twitter, I'm like, ah!
Is there a way to flip your phone upside down so the button's on top? Like the screen?
I have no idea.
I don't think that's possible.
Is that Pip-Boy?
Yeah, I have modifications on it. I have a Stream Deck and the phone on it. For no reason. It's useful. So I'm gonna watch the stream on the
Zelda
phone.
Link is... Oh yeah, they said they're remaking this.
Let's take a look at that. Was a Zelda Maker. People really like this. They're eating this up. They're eating it up.
Dude, Link Awakening. Best game in the world.
Nintendo's just like, make your own damn game. It's pretty cool, though. If I was born 5 years before my time, maybe I would have gotten into Zelda. Maybe.
Maybe.
I was born in 91. I don't know. It doesn't really matter, but...
Oh, you're older than me. I'm like 93.
It doesn't mean anything. You're probably smarter than me. I mean, I can say that about everybody. I'm pretty dumb. Pretty dumb guy. What's up, Charlie Boy? Speaking of dumb people. No, I'm kidding. Charlie Boy, what are the chances we're going to... What?
What? What?
What are the chances we're going to see Mega Man Legends Remastered, Charlie Boy? If it doesn't happen now, Mega Man Legends Remastered, or if that comes out, I'm buying Switch. I'm buying every Nintendo, whatever console comes out on, I'm buying it. I'm just waiting
what?
For that.
Ooh, waifus. I think, is this another Dicey Warrior game?
Wait, Secret of Mana? Is this Secret of Mana? Have to do with mana? Secret of mana? Secret of mana?
Good quest. Look at this chat.
A lot of Dragon Quest this year.
Trails of Mana? Oh my god. It's a Trails of Mana.
What the?
Slash.
Trials of Mana is part of Secret of Mana?
Yeah.
I like Secret of Mana. It was a good game.
Yeah, they did.
Collection of Mana.
With Final Fantasy? Oh.
They're just showing trailers. There's no bullshit with Nintendo.
Yeah. Collection of mana. Ooh, that's actually a good deal.
Collection of trailers. Witcher for the Switch?
Mm-hmm.
Has that happened yet?
No. Are they putting Witcher 3 on
that's
Switch?
Pretty cool.
Boy. Don't throw my money out if I didn't already own the game.
The complete edition. The Switcher.
People have been asking for this for like forever.
Beloved students.
Let's all agree to meet back at the monastery exactly
I love Witcher.
5 years from today.
Like a class reunion?
You will come, won't you?
Why does the graphic look worse? What do you mean?
Years ago, we fought here as classmates.
As big class
you know what this
reunions
is?
Go.
This might be
the
a
worst in history.
It sounds like that tank game.
Kill every last one
sweet
of
them. Sweet memory, twisted by...
Fire Emblem, that's right.
Still, We have no choice but to eliminate those who cling to unreasonable ideas of justice.
Someone must put Even though I haven't touched my 3DS in like forever. So, three houses.
They can't play it forever. Hey, it's the guy from Berserk. What the fuck?
Yet we have the strength to scale the walls between us, to reach out our hands in friendship so we can open our true hearts to one another. That's how we win!
My teacher. Both sides of time are revealed to you. What shall you do?
This is beyond the switch.
This is beyond science.
First off, I'm going to be like, on the Switch, that's actually like part of mainline stuff.
Nintendo stuff comes out sooner and they show more trailers. They just do everything better.
Nintendo Switch is the only gaming console you can play, not only on your TV at home, but anywhere you go.
Nintendo, I know.
What?
In fact, with a system like this, it might be fun to
Nintendo,
play Resident Evil.
My money is so bad.
Like this.
I give it. Come 2 weeks.
That's cool. The Switch is a pretty cool console. I'll admit it, okay? I'll admit it when I seize it.
Wait, did it say Resident Evil?
This is perfect, right?
Yeah.
Two? One?
Probably two on Switch. I don't know if it's already on Switch. I have no idea.
It's not.
So it probably is.
No lights.
So I guess this is like Wesker's place?
The Switch has like perfect capabilities to be like an arcade shooter. Like the Wii was. I had some games for like arcade style.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do this.
Resident Evil. I watched this be a whole new mobile game. Yeah, probably I need to.
Try. So what's through there?
Barry!
No, first game.
I wonder if they'll get the save glitch I had where I had to go back 2 hours because it didn't save.
Okay.
Ooh, really? Yeah, this is a reboot for one, yeah.
Ow! Son of
just bonked my knee.
Oh, Resident Evil 5, nice. And 6, that's good co-op action right there. Resident
Evil. Two more. Oh, 5 and 6.
That's pretty good.
Playing a Resident Evil game in a place like that might not be my way to play, but
it's weird. Zero.
It's a weird time we live in where like games that came out like 10 years ago are being released again and we're excited about that on a new console.
Not gonna take it anywhere I go.
Nintendo should release like their own internet servers that's like free. That'd be awesome.
The Empire striking back or
and they could play anywhere with anyone at any time. Huh. The Japanese Iron Man.
Anime. That's what that is.
The Japanese Iron Man.
There's probably some planet eating type dude waiting for me up ahead. All yoked and powerful and trying to take over the world or something.
One Punch Man. No more heroes.
Amazing. Wait, I've seen this before. No.
But don't you worry. A hero descends. What? There are no heroes in this world?
Right, is some sort of an anime.
That's the hair I would use. That's the same glasses. That's the same coat I would use.
Here to save the world. I'm also just a passing assassin. Now let's do this. Start the game.
No More Heroes 3. Must be good if they made three of them.
T
is a garden of madness. I didn't even know there was two.
Yeah. There's so many games out there, you can't really follow all of them.
Marvelous is doing this.
This is Kaiser. He led an elite team of Contras during war.
Oh shit. This looks cool. HB is actually a cyborg. What the hell? Look, scuffed Guardians of the Galaxy.
This is Harakiri and her alien gut bucket. They survived by merging together during the alien wars. The gentleman, the sweetest bug you'll ever meet.
So I'll put a panda. So anime.
Basically, almost like a top-down shooter. Almost. Looks fun.
It seems like that, like they're changing camera positions.
Contra Rogue Corps.
Corp. It's a bit like freaking Nier Automata kind of way.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. We might get Mega Man, Charlie Boy. Something Mega Man, something.
Local co-op. That'd be fun. The hell's Contra?
You don't know what Contra is? Are you kidding? Are you kidding me?
I can play it right now though, apparently. Is this Zone of Enders?
It's like Xenoblade Chronicles 8. Don't give up. Begin the mission. It's your call, rookie.
The battle's already started? If you get in our way, we will eliminate you.
Look a lot like freaking Zone of Enders.
The Avengers?
Zone of Enders.
Oh, I don't know what that is. This looks interesting though, a little bit. Looks like an MMO, but like co-op. Only co-op. Hmm. 15 FPS.
Everybody, one guy like Gundam. Oh,
Dame we don't get Machina.
Japan does.
What could this be?
Demon X Machine. No. Comes out. Okay, to be honest, I read that as freaking June 13th. I'm like, what day?
Oh, yeah. Oh, this looks like, yeah, Ridley, the game. The chat knows what I'm thinking. They know what's going on.
Remind me a lot of Star Fox.
Panzer Dragon. The problem with these games are all like expensive. Sherlock. It adds up. You gotta pick like two. You can't play everything.
Panzer Dragon?
From Pants?
That didn't release. It's like freaking what?
We held a Pokemon Direct for the latest games in the series. Pokemon Sword.
Sword. Pokemon Shield. Why? Who's gonna pick Shield? Who the hell?
The Galar region, the location of your new adventure, and some new Pokemon you'll encounter there.
Captain America fans.
It will be a while until these games launch, so please stay.
I wonder like how open world this game is gonna be.
By the way, are you getting that? Games,
you can use certain functions of the Pokemon Plus accessory. Like literally been to Pokemon since like freaking Emerald.
Pokemon from one of these games out for a stroll through the real world with you.
How about yourself?
Oh, I like this.
You may not be able to use the device as a game controller, but if you spend some quality time with a favorite Pokemon of yours, then something good might happen. In the Nintendo booth at this year's E3, fans can play Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield for the first time anywhere in the world.
Damn. That's what it's all about.
In this gameplay demo, you can challenge one of the gyms in the Galar region,
yeah,
the one and only water gym. Where the water type gym leader Nessa will be there waiting for you.
like her gloves. I like everything about her.
If you're attending this year's show, I encourage you to experience the battle between Dynamax Pokemon, which is an advanced strategy from this region. Also, immediately after this Nintendo Direct,
why is he so hella cute?
Stay tuned for live gameplay of Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield.
That's some giant ass Pokemon. Live.
Hey, what's up with
and
that?
Now I'd like to shift gears.
How can you flip Pokemon like that in a Pokeball?
I like that Pokeball idea. That might get me to buy some shit. I'm not gonna buy the Switch just for Pokemon. For you. As you know, Earth is currently under extra-dimensional
attack. Chimeras. Damn, Nintendo is going hard today.
Yeah, they have like so many games. At this rate, they're really going for that year. Lineup. Humankind will be pulled into the Chimera's dimension. They want the most games being shown. Obviously, this is not a mistake. This is not an accident. They're showing so many trailers. They know what they're doing. They know.
We're winning E3 today, boys.
We know what's going on. Stando. Someone said Stando. Props. It's weird that Nintendo's
Whoa,
in the morning.
Bayonetta stuff right there. That little freaking time freeze.
Oh yeah, the witch time. I'll give you some parting advice.
Your power, it's not the blessing you think it is. So, using your stand? Legionis and Allegiant are perfectly synchronized. It's like they're two parts of one body. No use! The override release isn't going through! That's impossible. And when half of that body is about to die, the Legion's survival instincts kick in to save it.
No way! There's no way! What good could this possibly be? It's a long shot, but it's the only shot we have. It's all up to you, my friend. A blessing from the Legion. Or maybe I should say, a curse. Interesting. Back now. I've gotta know the whole truth. He's still alive out there. I know he is. All right. So many games. The treehouse.
Astrian chain. Astrian. That seems cool. I'll buy it.
Not
Whoa! Platinum Games did it. Okay, now I'm like buying. I love Platinum Games.
Fallout New Vegas for Switch. Okay, top-down shooter. A lot of these little arcadey games. These are games I would play if I wasn't like a streamer. Death by our hands is not an honor they have earned. I like that one on the right. Marvel.
They deserve something much worse.
Even with this stone at my command, this may not be a battle we can win.
Is that guy's voice? We can beat Gandalf? It. Keep fighting.
Jump in anytime now, darlings.
Is this the Marvel one?
It's like an isometric game, whatever it's called.
Ooh, she.
Isometric. All hope is fleeting. I like these kind of games.
Oh my god, waifu!
Diablo style.
This game was kinda fun.
There's so much Marvel. Ultimate Alliance
Not
3.
Marvel, man.
Is it only on Switch? No.
Oh. Hey, Thanos. Sup, Thanos? Marvel 3. The Black Order.
Shovel Woman.
Wait, what?
I think the... Oh shit, that's pretty cool. For the females. That's nice.
You mean Zelda game?
Cadence of Hyrule. Nice. I'm just showing a game after game here. Oh god, Sonic and Mario again. Olympics 2019, Andy.
Comes out in 2 days. Look at all these games that McDonald's can force me to buy.
Huh?
I said, look at all these games that McDonald's forcing me to get.
Yeah. They haven't won me over. With the Pokemon, they almost did. That sounds cool. Are you playing 8-bit mode? 8-bit mode. This is like, this is pretty cool.
Did Peach punch Tails in the Tails like?
It's like Mario Tennis, Golf, everything. Published by Sega.
So, what do you think so far?
They don't think of like follow-up information weirdest things ever. Fans have been waiting for.
Please take a look.
Mario and Sonic at the Olympics.
Your attention, please. The Nook Inc. getaway package.
That Nintendo's crazy and they deserve my money.
If they showed Mega Man Legends, I don't know what I would do. I don't know what I would do. I would lose my shit. That's like the only game I'd lose my shit over. Yo, people like this shit. Look at them. Yeah. People are crazy, man. It's weird when you see people excited about something you don't care about it at all. Like, it's so interesting.
I've never played Animal Crossing.
I wanted to. I never did though. I want to. Maybe I might buy a Switch. If please, God, Mega Man Legends, just give it to me.
Someone throw it at him.
Do you even know about Mega Man Legends? Do you even know?
Mega Man. I haven't played Mega Man since like freaking the one on the Game Boy Advance, that battle brawl thingy one.
That sucked.
That ended it.
To in my opinion. I didn't like it. Animal Crossing, it's like you're in charge of a town. Holy shit, next year, that's a big deal. It's like they need a whole year.
It's a remake.
That'd be cool if like in a game you can get...
It might not be. It might be a whole new game.
That'd be cool if you can get like Switch points where you can buy games with it by playing a game.
Originally, we announced this title
cool.
as a 2019 release.
It's like getting paid.
However, we need to change its release date to March 20th of 2020. To ensure that the game is the best it can be, we must ask you to wait a little longer than we thought. We hope you look forward to the latest installment of Animal Crossing.
Delayed scam.
On Nintendo Treehouse Live, the game's producer, Mr. Nogami, and the director, Ms. Kilgoku, will come on for
Kilgoku.
A live demonstration of some early moments in the game, so please stick around until it starts. By the way, there are many different types of games coming to Nintendo Switch from Nintendo and our partners. So,
by the way,
prepare a highlight reel to show you what's in store for 2019 and beyond.
I had to like reset my thing like four times. What the hell?
Maybe switch browsers. Oh, Spyro, nice. That's cool.
I'm still playing through that.
Yeah, me too. I have to play the third one next. I'm on the third one.
I'm the second world in the first game. I'm very late to the game.
This is good for the kids to play like different types of games. They get to experience more games. I'm happy for them, really. Not everyone can have a cool computer.
Elder Scrolls, Blade,
Doom Eternal. That's nice. Yeah, you gotta give it to Nintendo.
So where's my Bayonetta 3? Nintendo.
I don't know. Oh, nice. They get Dead by Daylight. Is that cross-platform, though?
No idea. I never played the game.
It's pretty... Mm-hmm. It's okay. It's pretty cool arcade, like jump in, jump out kind of game. A lot of great games on Nintendo Switch, I'll tell you. If I had a kid, I would buy him the Switch over everything else. It's easier to use, you know? Portable. It's pretty.
They can play Minecraft whenever they want.
Yeah, you don't need a TV. Just play it on there. That's cool. You gotta give it to Nintendo. You gotta give it to them. I think the merger to a portable and you can switch to TV anytime is the best thing. That's pretty cool. Innovation.
Give me the charger, you'd be fine.
When you think Nintendo, you think innovation. Crazy shit.
They turned a console into a handheld. That's what they did. Network. So well. Dauntless.
Yeah, so they don't. Yeah, because like handhelds died or some shit. Because the phones. I don't know.
Mario Maker. I'm gonna have so much fun with Mario Maker, but the issue is you cannot play with your friends. I'm so sad.
Donkey Kong 64 remake. Or a new story altogether.
Might be Banjo-Kazooie.
Oh my god.
Watch me be like, hey, we're remaking.
Oh, yeah. Dude, what the fuck, dude? They teased it.
Banjo-Kazooie Smash? Oh, fuck you. Fuck you.
Debated.
I hate you.
Amazing.
I hate you.
In Smash? Or is the new game? What Smash?
The Smash. Debated. Debated.
Yeah, that's cool. I love the Banjo-Kazooie games. Maybe we'll get a new one day. Great characters.
So we got Joker, and we got him. Joker.
Best crossover ever. Someone says I'm crying. Everyone's crying.
Dude, I'm actually pumped for this character. I'm really pumped. I don't play like Smash like that, but I'm pumped for this character.
If you get a Switch, you have to get Smash wasn't Duck Hunt and Pokemon.
Please stay tuned for more information about DLC in the future.
He comes up fall.
As for Nintendo Switch, we have more games in development beyond what we've shown you today.
It's right around the corner.
I'm looking forward to the day we can introduce them to you. Speaking of, before we end this Direct, I actually have one more thing to show you.
Legends.
Thank you
Mega
very
Man
much
Legends
for watching.
Out of
Until
nowhere.
Next time.
It's not Legends.
Bayonetta 3? Bayonetta 3?
I don't think it is either.
Fuck you.
By the style, you can tell. This is Zelda DLC or some shit. Yeah.
I think I'll add another thing with it.
The rat's actually dead?
The next mansion. I'll play it. There's a new waifu though. It's not the waifu anymore. No, it was Zelda. Dude, I'm so happy what they did with Zelda.
Is that that transvestite woman? No.
Yeah.
Zombie door?
Well, looks like I have to get Breath of the Wild on Switch and not ever play my Wii U version.
A sequel. Oh, it's a new game. This is a new game entirely.
So, wait, what?
It's a whole new game they're working on.
Oof. Battle Royale.
Hey, good morning, everybody, and welcome to E3 2019. I'm Doug Bowser from Nintendo of America, and he is Bill Trinan from Nintendo Treehouse. We're here at the Nintendo booth. We're going to spend a couple of minutes talking about what we just saw in that Nintendo Direct, and we're going to give you a sneak peek of the booth. So, Bill, I don't know about you, but I think there's a lot of folks out there that are pretty excited about what they just saw.
Is it over?
Well, Doug, I think it goes without question that I, myself, am a huge fan of the Legend of Zelda series. Like a lot of people, I put a lot of time.
How much is a Switch? Like $300? 300?
So, personally,
not
I'm
my Reggie. Not my Reggie.
We're not getting new
not
DLC. We are getting a full sequel, a brand new
I think
game
like three,
in development.
Is.
For
like for
Nintendo
a new one,
Switch.
Buy like a
so
three young like
hopefully everyone out there is excited
I
as well.
So.
Maybe.
Certainly,
pushing
if you're a
it,
Zelda
yeah.
fan, there was a lot to like in this Nintendo Direct. A lot of other things as well. Lots of games for lots of players, from Dragon Quest XI S to even things like Panzer Dragoon, the Dark Crystal, Astral Chain. Looking great. Was there anything in the Direct that stood out to you?
You played Crash Bandicoot Racing on the Switch.
Luigi's Mansion 3. I'm a huge fan of the series, and I look forward to being able to walk through this the various levels of this spooky hotel with my sidekick Guigi. And the thing I'm actually really looking forward to is the new Poltergust and its updated capabilities, including the slam move. It's going to be a lot of fun killing ghosts with ghosts.
That's right.
And
it feels really good, too.
Yeah, I have a feeling this game's going to suck up a
you
little bit of my
You can get
pre
on Switch for $279.
That was a dad joke, sorry. You know, one other thing I'm really excited about is what we got on the floor here, and that is Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield.
That's right. I think this year is probably the most space we've ever dedicated in our booth to a Pokemon game. The booth looks fantastic. I think we're going to go ahead and give you a quick sneak peek of that.
It's really
it's
well.
Themed
it's like an art
on the water
form.
Gym, and what we've done is we have recreated the gym leader battle arenas. So everybody here at E3 is going to get a chance to play Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield.
That's a lot of room.
Of the gym leader battle arena, and I think that's going to be really
great
for them. But we have something special for everybody watching live.
You say you're bored.
Our
you know
very
you're
first
bored.
Segment on Nintendo Treehouse Live this year at E3 is going to be Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield, and we're going to give people a look at a much bigger part of that game. And I think that the team is almost ready, so I'm going to head over there in just a second, and we're going to get that kicked off.
Fantastic.
Great. Thank you, everybody, for watching, and stay tuned for some Treehouse Live coming up right away.
Great. Thanks, everyone, for viewing. Make sure you tune in next for Treehouse Live, and tune in for the next 3 days to Treehouse Live. We'll have discussions with developers.
I say when it comes to Nintendo,
building, we'll give you some sneak peeks.
Like this E3,
first play,
they did it better
really
than everybody else
to,
because they're releasing their games now.
Chance to see everything that we have to offer at
sooner.
E3 this year. Thank you very much.
Compared to
Hi everyone, welcome to Nintendo Treehouse Live 2019.
How do you stream a Switch game though?
And we're here to kick off to
like,
the first
the same
view
way
of
you
the live
do, like,
gameplay
with, like,
of Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield.
Xbox,
I'm here with
PS4,
our very, very special
card.
Guests. Mr. Masuda, who is the game producer. Mr. Amori, who
like
is
you
the
can only
game
stream
director,
it when it's docked.
And they're accompanied by David from the Pokemon Company.
Okay.
Thank you very much. They also have a little cameo appearances of Score Bunny, Grookey and Sobble. They're super, super cute.
I want to buy like Nintendo stuff
Bill,
now from all that.
Just cartwheeled.
So if I want to buy it, a lot of people are buying shit now for Nintendo.
Off, there was a lot of announcements.
Right now is a good time to get
Pokemon Direct
Switch,
last week,
now,
and then there was some more information that came out this morning. Mr. Masuda, Mr. Mori, do you have anything to add to those,
like,
that information?
Main, like, I really want this game. Besides, you had, you know, wait for Smash. They only had Breath of the Wild, Mario Kart, and if you're a Xenoblade fan, the rest of the game is just ported to the Switch.
We have the Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu 1 for sale
at
$4.19.
If you like Pokemon,
so we're really happy to finally
you,
be able to
I'd say if you like
one
Pokemon
of the big
Go on
the game,
mobile,
Dynamax,
I think you'll like
as well
it more.
As the legendary Pokemon. I think that's really getting a lot of the fans out there excited for the game.
Because, like, let's say if you play the original Pokemon, you may not like
really,
it because
really
you probably will miss
gonna
the dominant Pokemon catching them. Because Let's Go, Eevee, and Let's Go Pikachu, when you meet a Pokemon, you don't fight them. You just have to catch them and hope to God you get them.
You don't fight them?
You can only fight trainers.
Oh, interesting. Interesting. I didn't know that. What the hell? What was the difference between a 2DS and a 3DS? What the fuck?
One was bigger, I think.
So 2DS is like shittier?
So in the direct we just saw, we revealed the water type gym, gym challenge and the gym leader Nessa. But in today's Treehouse Live, I want to demonstrate via actual live gameplay the wild area as
what?
Well as some max raid battle.
Since they said they updated
that's right. And the wild area is something that's
the shop
brand
where
new for the Pokemon
Switch.
Games. We
must see what's in
the
shop.
An area like this. Can you maybe
I would buy Epic Yarn. That was fun to play.
What it is.
Epic Yarn. I don't know about these other games though. Oh, you broke your Fallout 76 Crash Cherry there. Congratulations. Wait, what are these games? These are like $1 games.
This is really kind of the first time that we've had such a huge wide open area in the Pokemon main series RPG.
You don't always talk about games. What you mean?
You really find the widest variety of wild Pokemon out of any area in the games. And it also changes the Pokemon you can encounter depending on the
I'm mind blown up about that freaking sequel. I wouldn't think they would do a sequel like another Zelda game like so soon. You know what I mean?
I guess it's
and the wild area,
nah, I think it's the right time.
So your adventure will take
Kirby
you
Battle Royale, what the fuck?
The wild area multiple times, and as you can see on screen here, you can control the camera freely in this area to better find hidden items that are lying about and also see the Pokemon that are flying above in the sky.
Well, yes, and it looks like
PS2 graphics
Pokemon
pog
out in the field here, correct?
Is Sword and Shield right now? They're showing. You can actually see the Pokemon in the grass. That's pretty cool. It's like a 3D people wanted this shit. Except it still transitions into a battle. Which is fine, it's like a half-half.
The last remnant from Switch now. That's cool.
Last remnant. You like that? I forget what that is.
I've seen like videos of it. It's like an RPG that was on PS4.
Random encounter, so you
it's
don't
remastered.
Know what Pokemon you're going to encounter. We wanted to have a mixture of both types of encounters in these games to also let players enjoy that excitement of, you know, not knowing what they're going to encounter. Yeah, that's great. It looks like we've got a lot of different types of Pokemon.
There's so many games that like kind of want to play now on Switch.
Can you get
so happy they ported freaking Guilty Gear?
Is it possible to transfer from the first gen Pokemon all the way up to the newest gen? Just trading? Like transfer the first Pokemon you ever catch to the newest game? Is it possible? Elmo, are you kidding me?
There's definitely a lot of Pokemon to encounter, and of course, as you can see here, the battle system, you know, it's the traditional turn-based battle where you choose moves to
now
gotta
see
the wild Pokemon before you can catch
Nintendo thingy bobber.
They have no first gen Pokemons, huh?
I love first gen.
And you'll find that their, you know, Pokemon abilities are back as well as the
first gen, the best gen.
So there's definitely a lot of depth to the battle system. Yeah, certainly.
Special offer.
Look forward to the depth within that battle system, and they'll be able to enjoy that both within the game as well as in their one-on-one battles as well.
So, and well, so the deep battle system, まあ、多分楽しみにしてるファンもいると思うんですけども、こういう野生ポケモンとのバトルだけではなくて、他のプレイヤーとの通信対戦を通しても、できるということですよね。そうですね。通信で対戦したり、その奥深いバトルを待ってる方もいらっしゃると思うんで、そういった方にはすごく満足いただけるようなバトルになっていますね。
Yeah, I definitely.
Kid Icarus is now on it. Punch Man, Star Soldier, Super Mario, the Lost Levels. The Adventures of Link.
You know, really compete with each other.
あと、今雨降ってますけども、雨降ってるんで、その水タイプのポケモンが出てます。で、場所によってはその天候が変わったりすることもあって。
It's funny because the journal hadn't, like, none of the games had got leaked, which is a great thing.
Yeah, you can see it's actually raining right now where we're wandering about, and depending on the weather condition, the kind of certain types of Pokemon will appear more frequently. Right now, we'll see more water type Pokemon, and maybe if it was snowing, you would see more ice type Pokemon, for example.
Cool, you have a weather system. That's pretty cool.
I'm
so far delayed. What the
heck? If you come back a different day, the weather may be completely different. So we really think that players will have a lot of fun coming back multiple times and seeing the different Pokemon that appear depending on the weather conditions.
So we were talking about the different encounters, but it looks like Terry can also whistle to attract Pokemon, and different Pokemon have
That'd be cool if
there
was like, you have a camera as well, like Fallout 76. Implement Pokemon Snap into the game. That's what Switch games are. They're just a bunch of modifications to one game, but they make them into separate games. Pokemon Snap, Pokemon Cat.
Oh, you're on the Nintendo one?
Yeah. Wait, this is the Nintendo directly from the source.
Flying high above, you can't really, you know, encounter them very easily, so you have to attract their attention by whistling at them.
Metapod, okay, that's a first gen.
Like you said,
that's a good sign.
Pokemon react differently than
so there might be a Squirtle somewhere.
For example, or others may be curious about you and approach you. Terry's doing a great job of battling and capturing Pokemon here in the wild area.
Just got my Metapod.
A switch, let me tell you.
Expanding the party.
That's right. So I think for
so you couldn't battle Pokemon in Let's Go.
This part of the wild area as we
what?
Kind of head closer
you can
to
only fight trainers, you said.
Yep.
That should give us a good sense of this one particular.
But it was all first gen.
Area, but clearly, there's a lot more to the wild area.
I was a hunter. Randomly.
How this is? It was kind of like how Let's Go was, but Let's Go had the your typical see Pokemon, just go in there and hope the guy can catch it.
I love the 3D world. I love that shit. Now it's snowing.
Yeah, this is just a small portion of the wild area. If you wanted to walk really far out there, there's lots of stuff to discover, and it's much wider. There's a lot of available.
All right, so there are Gen 1s.
Pokemon that you may want to go try and seek out.
Machops. Well, the only way to like make Machoke evolve, you have to trade it, right?
Yeah.
That sucks.
Yeah, we were actually just, I think Terry was showing the crouching down motion.
And apparently they're making a Pokemon cloud system where you're able to like store your Pokemon from another games, apparently.
Oh, that's sick. Interesting.
We had talked about how when the weather changes, that specific Pokemon, like
a Machoke right there.
So like right now, it's hailing, so there's a.
Well, if you caught a Machop, then you just see a Machoke down the road. It's like fuck. Alpha. It's Tyler
yeah,
one.
Since it's snowing right now. We might see a more ice type Pokemon appearing in the field.
And here we have Terry taunting Machoke here.
Always picking my fights.
He's basically a human at this point.
Oh yeah, that new Neptunia game's coming out on the Switch.
I have no idea what that is. I have no idea.
Neptunia is like an RPG game that makes fun of all gaming. Like each of the main characters are their own systems. Pretty fun series. They do not take themselves seriously whatsoever. They're all waifus.
I see it. Oh, I've seen this game before. The hell?
And right now, they're like Neptunia games are more focused on spin-off games. That we saw in one of the Nintendo Directs was that they have made a mainline entry in forever. Navigate the wild area. We saw the return of the bicycle coming soon.
Look, when you use the bike, you have like a helmet on. It's so stupid.
At least we know like their clothes can change now. Wait, why is electricity?
And what?
The bike had like electricity.
Oh. Are you going in the water? That's cool. You don't need surf anymore, I guess.
See that electricity, man. Like, what?
It really helps you get around the wild area very quickly. You can even hold down the B button.
So that's what items gonna look like now. Yeah. Like flash.
Why is there electric there? What's going on with that? Oh, to go faster. There you go. Riding over the water, so it definitely helps you get around. For some reason. This is definitely a bike I wish I had when he's wearing a helmet, but he has electricity on a bike in the water. Okay. Unlimited power.
Unlimited blade works.
That's true. That's a secret. That's how they do it with the car batteries, I think.
What the hell is Gloria? Explain, what is Gloria?
The thing that really sells me right now is that Pokeball, you can put a Pokemon in it and walk around with it. That's cool.
And of course, Godin. If you're getting this game, what starter will you start out with?
Probably the water type. I would call him Uwu or something. Gloria.
Now, one other thing that we've noticed here on the left side is that we're seeing some icons.
That could be the Pokemon name that is like the main.
Mm-hmm.
Watch.
Wait, what's those lights?
Watch, they're about to talk about it. Gloria is probably the Pokemon in the ball.
Okay, that makes sense because one of the ball and then you can take them out. Okay.
We're calling that through this device called the Y-Comb in the games, and you can actually have these what we're calling stamps appear to kind of show what other players are up to.
Oh, like your friends, like what they're doing?
So this is actually Masuda-san playing right next to us. He's playing the Gloria character there, but this stamp is signifying that he wants to trade with us.
Trade?
Multiplayer pod.
You can use these stamps to kind of invite people to battle, trade, or even try and get other players to join you in a max raid battle.
Were there other games with co-op? Pokemon games?
Let's go. You can play with your friend right next to you. Catch Pokemon.
At all times, or you have to join them?
At all times. So let's say you're right next to me. I'm like, here, help me catch Pokemon. I throw you a controller, and you're
there's a lot of different reasons that players will come back to the wild area.
Makes catching so much more easier.
You can kind of encounter them, other players, if you're connected in the wild area and see them in your game.
That's pretty cool.
Internet to see on Sereba, Sekaijuno, player,
and this works either via local wireless with other players that are nearby playing at the same time. You can
this
also connect
Twitch
to the internet to kind of play with other players.
Local wireless.
That's right. And it looks like now Terry has gotten to the town that we were heading towards.
Oh. Right, but there's some lights in the background, these red pillar of lights. Could you guys explain what these are?
ちょっと目的地に街に今到着したんですけども、はい、ちょっと遠くに赤い光の柱みたいなものがあるんですけども、はいはい、それって何でしょうか？
そうですね、あれはですね、ポケモンの巣でして、で中に非常に強力な、ダイマックスポケモンがいます。その、
Raid?
まあ、パワー、エネルギーが赤い光で出ていますね。
So those are actually what are called Pokemon dens, and there's a red light emitting from them when there is a Dynamax Pokemon inside. So the red light kind of represents the energy of the Dynamax phenomenon.
What's a Dynamax?
光のところに行くと、Max Raid Battle をチャレンジすることができます。
And what that means for the player is that you can go there and encounter that Dynamax Pokemon in a Max Raid Battle.
Well, perhaps we should show what the max raid battle is like.
そうですね。じゃあ早速じゃあマックスレイドバトル
も、oh, so the raids?
ちょっとやってみたいと思います。
はい。
Okay. What Pokemon slowly like going towards at most?
Do said max raid battle, Mr. Mori, Mr. Masuda, could you explain a little bit more to the people watching at home about what the Dynamax feature is?
ちょっとダイナマックスについてもう少し詳しく教えてもらっていいですか？
そうですね、これまでですね、メガ進化とかゼット技っていう要素があったんですけども、今作ポケモンがパワーアップする新要素として入ったのがこのダイマックスです。
So Dynamax is actually a new way to power up your Pokemon in these games. It replaces what we've seen previously, for example, Mega Evolution and Z moves.
Victor, ready up.
そうですね。ダイマックスバトルなんですけども、好きなポケモンを1匹選んで戦うことができます。で、今回はボックスからも1匹選べるので、そこから1匹選んでルカリオをちょっと選んで戦ってみようと思います。
And each player participating in the battle can choose one Pokemon from either their party or from the box. So it's important to choose one of your stronger Pokemon since you before you go into the max raid battle.
でも今回1匹なんで途中で交換はできないのでこの1匹大切に戦ってください。
And you only get to choose one and you can't change during the battle, so you got to make sure it's a good choice.
So strategy and communication is incredibly key here.
Oh, so you have three different avatars?
プレイヤー同士のコミュニケーションというのは非常に大切になってくるんですよね。
4人で戦うので、その役割分担と連携がすごい大事になって
ます。That looks pretty cool.
Yeah, cooperation between the players and also really determining the roles is going to be very important to defeating the opponent.
まあ、例えば、タイプ相性の強い、まあ、良い技を持っているポケモンが中心となって攻撃して、で、戦況に合わせて補助技とか、まあ、回復技で味方をサポートするというのがすごい大事だと思います。
So, yeah,
once you get into the battle, identifying maybe which of the four Pokemon will have the best type advantage to be the main attacker, and also like who can be the best kind of supporter or the Pokemon that will use healing moves to support the team.
Yes, I'm playing as Togekiss, so for my...My first move, I've used this.
I guess the car isn't actually.
そうですね。僕はトゲキスを使ってるんですけれども、今リフレクターを出して、ちょっと
チーム。My greatest fear though is like buying a new console, then like a year later it's out of date. They have a new console already coming out.
攻撃が強かったとしても防げることをやっていきます。
That'll definitely help protect against some of these powerful attacks.
See, when it comes to handheld, I only think about that for like 3DS, because printing it out and making another one, like,
so,
at this point of me buying
this
thing.
I guess we should do roll call. I'm playing Ludicolo, so I'm actually just got hit.
Does the 3DS actually look 3D?
Steelix is doing multiple attacks.
Yeah,
there's
actually like a 3D option.
ちょっと今、ハガネールが連続で技をいろいろ出してきたんですけれども、それって結構不公平ですよね。
ああ、そうですね。
How can you burn Steelix?
まあ、状況に合わせて回攻撃してきたりとかですね。
So yeah, when you're going up against a Dynamax Pokemon, sometimes they will take multiple moves, and so you really kind of can't let your guard down.
Jim, Tom, the Windy, I'm using, but just a little bit bigger, please.
So I'm probably a video I'm recorded. I'm Tom character here playing Arcanine. Is it okay if I use Dynamax?
Absolutely.
Oh,
cool.
Go ahead. I think we need all the help we can get.
Yes.
ぜひお願いします。
ダイマックスなんですけども、
ダイマックス
各ターン、プレイヤーは1回しかまあできないんですね。で、プレイヤー側が順番にダイマックス権利が回ってきます。で、バトル中にどのプレイヤーか1人しか、まあ、1回しかダイマックスできないので、このダイマックスタイミングも非常に重要となります。
And you can make a big
deal. The ability to use Dynamax that actually rotates between the players each turn.
How do you
turn
the Pokeball?
You can only use Dynamax once throughout the entire battle, so it's important to kind of identify what the exact right timing is to be able to exploit the its power.
A next gen Pokemon thing would be like to dye their fur and shit to make it like different from other people. Customize the colors, because otherwise this just looks like any other Arcanine. They'll probably do that one day.
That attack didn't like very
much damage. Moves, which are much more powerful, and they also have these added effects, like you saw the drought was just triggered based off Arcanine's attack.
Yeah, and they look really cool too.
Yeah, definitely. I think there's. It's very impressive.
And as we can see, Steelix just put up a barrier around him.
Oh, that's annoying. The teacher got only one bar. Dude, no. The question is, how many times can the AI interrupt barriers?
I wonder what people who are in the world like see you doing right now in the raid battles. Does it show your character in the game still?
What happens is once his HP is reduced, it'll put up this kind of barrier that you have to take down before it will actually start taking lots of damage again. But you can see that there's a couple of different like parts to the gauge, and each time you hit it with a damaging attack, one of those will be reduced. So even if your Pokemon isn't particularly powerful in the attack department, it can still reduce the gauge by just using a damaging attack.
Okay, so
well, yes, so you can see my Togekiss used Dazzling Gleam, which is not particularly effective, but was still good enough to break that barrier down.
So it's a good opportunity for even the weaker Pokemon to,
See, I wish that they would really tell us how much damage they're actually doing.
And Dynamax moves, if you use it against it, it'll actually take down two gauges. Two slots of the gauge.
Like damage numbers?
Yeah.
So yeah, you guys have broken down the barrier, so you just need to defeat the Pokemon.
Oh yeah, true.
We're very close, but one thing that we haven't talked about is that storm that's kind of lurking around Steelix. Could you talk a little bit about that?
So only one Pokemon could be giant? At a time?
That's really the kind of the energy of the Dynamax phenomenon just kind of brewing above their head.
It looks like poop.
Looks like you're able to, you're probably going to be able to defeat
floating poop.
Without too much trouble. Follow you, make Togekiss the center of attention.
Dragon Ball Z
that was actually pretty good.
For sure. Catch him. You can catch
him.
So
now all of us have a chance to actually catch this Steelix. And so by catching it, can we add them to our party?
It's like normal again.
Actually,
like turns normal.
Every player who participates in the battle are able to get a chance to catch it. But even if you don't catch the Pokemon, there's still a variety of rewards for the players that participate to get items and such that will help be beneficial in their adventure.
Actually, that monkey Pokemon looks cool too.
So it's definitely something that
I don't care about the bunny one.
To play along with their friends, but also
the water and the leaf one are cool.
Yes, my my daughter has really gotten into Pokemon with Pokemon Let's Go, so I'm very excited.
But do they all get the Pokemon if they catch it?
In Pokemon Sword and Pokemon
Shield. What is that one player does?
Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee で娘がすごいポケモン好きになったので、まああの結構こう一緒にマックスレイドバトルができることを楽しみにしております。
そうですね。So I think Masuda-san, I think there was another topic that you wanted to touch on.
まああの実機プレイは多分以上になると思うんですけども、ちょっと増田さんからお話ししたいことがあるっていうのは聞いたんですけども。
はい。そうですね。あのちょっと皆さんにお伝えしたいことがあります。ポケモンホームはあのポケットモンスターシリーズとポケモン GO のポケモンたちを集めることが新しいサービスで、 もちろんこのソードシールドとも連動します。
Yeah, there's one thing I'd like to talk about, and it's about the Pokemon Home service that we recently announced. So it will connect with the Pokemon RPGs as well as Pokemon Go to allow players to really gather all of their Pokemon in a single location. And of course, it will also work with the Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield games.
ただし、ここでこれまでポケモンバンクのサービスをご利用していただいているファンの皆さんにちゃんとお伝えしたいなと思っていることがあります。
But there is one important change from the previous Pokemon Bank service that I want to tell all of its users about.
これまで のポケットモンスターシリーズは例えばサンムーンではアローラ図鑑に含まれていないポケモンも、まあ、全種類をポケモン版から連れてくることができました。 I thought you'd like take that off, be all serious.
So in previous games that worked with the Pokemon Bank service, you were able to, for example, in Sun and Moon, bring over any Pokemon even if they weren't in the Alola Pokedex.
でハードが Nintendo Switch になって、まあ、ポケモン1匹ずつに対しての、まあ、表現自体も、まあ、非常にこう、豊かになる。
But with the transition to the Nintendo Switch hardware, with its, you know, it being much more powerful, allowing us to be much more expressive with each of the individual Pokemon.
もう一つ、ポケモンはもう今では図鑑番号で言うとやっぱり800を超えてます。
And now we're well over 800 Pokemon species in the games.
その中で1匹ずつ大切にクオリティを上げて、バトルバランスも取って、
Is it really 800 Pokemon?
They're going to do something special for the thousandth Pokemon. They're going
to
make it a big deal.
What the best way to move forward was really preserving the quality of all the different Pokemon while also, you know, taking into account the battle balance, having so many different Pokemon available.
Game Freak does a good job of Pokemon games.
So we don't keep fans waiting too long for every new entry in the series.
まあ、その結果今作から対応方針を変えることにしました。
And after a lot of discussion, we decided to come to kind of a new direction.
つまりですね、ポケモンホームとソードシールドの間を行き来できるポケモンをガラル図鑑に登場するポケモンに絞ることにしました。
And so what that means for Pokemon Sword and Shield is that players will be able to transfer their Pokemon from Pokemon Home only if they appear in the Galar region Pokedex.
Gallery.
図鑑の、まあ、舞台に合わせて、冒険の冒険の舞台に合わせて、こだわって登場するポケモンを、決めています。
Oh,
so
the new one.
Very careful. We spent a lot of time really thinking what the best selection of Pokemon to match the setting of the adventure would be.
さらに詳しい話は今後の取材とかインタビューでちゃんと説明していきたいと思います。
F.
So I'll talk more about the details in future opportunities.
Anytime you get rid of something, is it's sad.
ただポケモンバンクをご利用してくださってるファンの皆さんには少しでも早くお伝えしたい。
Pokemon Bank's a good idea, though.
お伝えさせていただきました。
I know there are a lot of users of the Pokemon Bank service who are looking forward to Pokemon Home, so I wanted to let them know what the change would be well in advance.
But of course, as somebody who's been hunting for a lot of shiny Pokemon in Pokemon Let's Go,
how much are you charging?
Any of those Pokemon that do appear in Pokemon Sword and Shield, I'll still be able to transfer. From Pokemon Let's Go into Pokemon Sword and Shield through Pokemon Home, correct?
まあ、レッツゴーピカチュウ、レッツゴーイーブイでたくさん色違いのポケモンを探して捕まえているんですけれども、はい、まあ、それらのポケモンがガラル図鑑に登場するのであれば、
はい、I always think someone's like joins the channel when they say hi.
転送するっていうのができるんですね。
そうですね。ホームを、経由して連れてくることができます。
That's right. Yeah, as long as they're in the Galar region Pokedex, you can transfer them from home.
That's great.Well,
that water type Pokemon looks so sad.
He does. I'm surprised they didn't put a smile on him. They would put a smile on every Pokemon. They're always happy.
And it's him.
Yeah, in the Galar region, you're going to find a lot of Pokemon, including a bunch of Pokemon that no one has discovered yet. So the games are definitely chock full of content.
ガラル図鑑を完成させるのも非常に大変だと思うんですけども、皆さんこう頑張って集めてほしいなと思います。
And it will be no small feat to complete the Galar region Pokedex, but I do hope the players
will
get their best in the region.
I do like the monkey.
I'm excited to see how the story unfolds.
His third form is probably like badass.
But is there anything else that you want to add before we?
That guy has a switch on the floor.
Yeah, I saw that. On
the
rug.
ゲームのストーリーとか、wild area
の furious rug.
楽しみにしてるんですけれども、まあちょっと最後にお二人から視聴者に向けて何かお言葉ありますでしょうか。
そうですね。先ほどマックスレードバトルを4人でやりましたけども、やっぱりやっていてなんか楽しいんですよね。ちょっと何ですかね。今までのポケモンの中ではなかった新しいシステムになってますんで、やっぱりこう4人でワイワイ楽しく。 あの友達と一緒に遊べるっていう仕組みはすごい皆さんにぜひ体験してもらいたいなと思ってます。
Yeah, for me, it definitely is the Max Raid Battles we just showed off. Playing together with your friends in this kind of cooperative battle feature that we've never had in the Pokemon series before is really just a lot of fun. I hope fans of the series will look forward to being able to try that for the first time.
そうですね。ワイルドエリアでいろんなプレイヤーと一緒にこう冒険したりするのってすごいやっぱり楽しくてですね。まあローカル通信で友達と一緒に遊んだり、まあ、インターネット通信を使って世界中のプレイヤーと、まあ、出会って。
And even other than the max raid battles, we of course have all the traditional, you know, multiplayer features where you can trade and battle with other players either nearby with the local wireless or to connect with other players, trainers from around the world using the connecting via the internet.
Great. Well, thank you very much for joining us today. Thank you all for watching.
I had to grab a friend just to
what
trade.
We're going to do is as we get ready for our next segment here on Nintendo Treehouse Live, we are going to go down to our Luigi's Mansion booth and give you all a sneak peek at what people are going to experience here on the show floor. It's a very, very special booth. So take a quick look at that, and then we will come back in just a few minutes for our very next segment, which I think a lot of people will be looking forward to very much. Thank you very much.
What's the next segment? What is it? How am I going to look forward to it if I don't know where it is?
Hey guys, I'm Morgan here with Audrey, and we are...
We're in a haunted hotel.
Yeah.
Dude,
Bill
they
said,
were like,
is
this
Luigi's Mansion booth, but this is not... I mean, we're in the booth.
How long
were
they? I like how they
like
set up
a fully built out haunted mansion, which is sort of where the game Luigi's Mansion 3 takes place.
Yeah, I think it might actually be haunted, but let's find out and take a look at this.
Yeah, so
really
we just wanted
booth.
You guys at home to get a look at this. This is where... we've got some players in here now, but this is when the booth opens soon. Where fans are going to get in here to play the game, but also be surrounded by this really cool ambiance.
Yeah, we've got a spooky fish cauldron, skulls, jack-o'-lanterns, you know, the whole...
Yeah,
I wish I had
a cauldron full of green goo and fish.
Absolutely, there are ghosts showing
was
up
Luigi
all
Mansion
over the walls, so
two?
Be careful,
did that take
step.
Place
yeah.
in a...
And we can see up above
in a mansion?
A lot of atmosphere
I guess
stuff
yeah.
happening.
I had to.
Have you ever played Luigi's Mansion?
Been exed out.
The
That's
first
just
one
not
only.
Nice. It's a little foreboding.
I played like a tiny bit of the first one. Tiny
I'm
bit.
I'm not sure if you guys are be able to hear the music at home, but there's a
Never
lot
owned
of
a game. Game to myself.
Sound effects happening. Weird, I don't even know. The
it's
kind of sounds you hear in a horror movie.
It's
basically.
Intensely ooky, it's true. And
got,
every now
I just saw a crow fly through
oh,
the air.
Oh, yes. And there, every now and then you'll hear Luigi go, Mario.
Oh,
and
God.
Step back here. And of course, you wouldn't have a haunted hotel without a bellman.
Yep. And there's a little black, there's a shape back up
yeah.
here. Something hanging from the wall.
We better investigate, because
like,
that's what you do.
What should we say, man?
In horror.
What should we say?
Horror themed area. Oh, it's fine. Morgan, why did you get scared like that?
I don't know. I don't
well,
know how that happened.
That's just creepy.
There's just things in here that it's. It,
yeah.
Things just happen.
It's fine.
So,
it's a little reception desk because we're at a hotel again. So, but nobody's here, Morgan. That's kind of strange.
Get a little closer.
Well, it's an abandoned lobby here what? In this haunted
hotel. Something's supposed
hotel.
To happen.
Nobody needs to worry about
I
any of that.
Another spider come down the wall over there.
Yeah, I've got more bellmen. We've got tons of creepy fog and ghosts all over the place.
I think something was supposed to happen.
You can see over here we've got all the gameplay oh. happening.
Yeah.
We've got. Oh!
Oh!
Ghost just flew by.
The ghost.
The cameraman sucks.
All over the place. Yeah, and this
dude, they
really
have no idea what
they're
doing.
Of Luigi's Mansion 3.
Yeah.
Well,
ghost, I like how the cameraman's focused on them the
yeah,
whole time,
so,
and then when he says there's a ghost there, he looks away.
Again, we're inside the convention center.
The
it is so
the game that sucks
there's
the
so
ghost.
Many like blackout curtains or whatever that
you
I don't I do not feel like I'm inside. I feel like
I think they're just stalling for the next
Absolutely.
Thing.
Absolutely. If you're
really,
here,
cool.
we encourage you to come and check
it's
this
like,
out.
It's like keep stalling, keep stalling.
We're gonna brave this haunted hotel for you.
I just saw two more ghosts run by.
Of course you did.
Somehow in midair above us.
That's right, people are going to be able to check out the game here, and of course later on Nintendo Treehouse Live at E3, we're going to get some live gameplay footage
yeah.
of this game as well, so please look forward to that.
Let's head back over here toward these, some of these...
Yeah, beware of ghosts, again.
I'll give it.
I love those sound effects that you hear piping in all over the place. We've got coins, we've got ghoulish laughs.
Yeah, we've got some fog, there's some fog coming in too from like... I don't know where it's coming from.
We don't
from.
Know where it's coming from, guys.
So let's go back over to these shapes over here. We didn't quite get a good look at all of them. There's a standard issue skull on a. I don't know what, a platter.
I think that's all the E3 stuff.
Like a giant. It looks like a stein.
Dude, that is also getting green.
I'll just have a sip, Morgan. Yeah. I'm sure it's delicious.
Your legs are also glowing.
I know.
There's some sort of lighting effects in here.
This is completely normal.
Games,
more
demos, and
everywhere
interviews.
Everywhere you look, a different ghost is popping up. It's really, really cool.
I think like this is one of those booth experience. People that come to the Nintendo booth, if they come in here, they're not going to forget it.
Oh no, it really is immersive. You just lose yourself in the game. You're in the game world right now. We got some cool chandelier action over there.
Yeah, I haven't seen Guiji yet. I feel like
he could
just slide through the wall at any moment. But
that would actually be pretty terrifying.
I know.
I think that's it. Basically.
Oh, and that song, that music.
Yeah,
you've got to love that music.
All right, well, we're going to see gameplay of this later, but right now we want to take it back to the stage for the first live gameplay of something else completely, something much happier than this, ooh. Animal Crossing New Horizons. Don't go anywhere.
See ya.
Bye.
Dude, this whole segment
back to
was not
Nintendo Treehouse Live at E3 2019.
I could have done better than that.
What we've got coming up here is something
they should have
that
went, like,
I think a lot
they should
of
do some crazy
are highly anticipating.
Yes.
This make
is
it interesting.
The world premiere
there's a chance they'll be fired, but at least
the
there's a chance
the
they won't be fired
series,
and be like internet memes. And they jump over the desk and like
into further depth
do some shit.
Some of the stuff that we saw
they jump
the
over the desk,
Direct,
pretend they're the welcome people.
So before we get too
do
much
something.
Further, I'm Sam.
You
I'm
didn't
here
live
with
life
Sam
enough
from Treehouse also. But we also have Kyogoku-san and Nogami-san from
right.
the development team
two
to
Sams.
Give us some development insight. Thank you so much for being here. And Noriko also will be translating.
So just to kick us off here, I think fans of the Animal Crossing series who watched the direct right after that noticed that this time we're sending them to a deserted island, which is quite different from the
game. All right, I think we're good here.
Can you tell us a little bit about why you chose a deserted island as the setting this time?
I'm not sure if I want to continue streaming or like take a break for like an hour or two, then come back.
When's the next? What is the next showing?
I think that's it. That's basically it. The next thing is the Konami announcement at 5:30, which is 8:30 Eastern. 5:30 California.
Konami.
What do they make? What games? Konami.
I think it'd be like, we're sorry for our issues we had for past 3 years.
The player living on a deserted island. There's actually two main reasons. And one of the reasons being that previously in the legacy titles, we had the player come to a pre-existing village and then have them start a life there and from scratch. But we thought maybe we can give the players a new experience.
What's up, Sally Bot?
Huh?
Oh, my stream.
Are you streaming too?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my bad. I didn't know that. I had no idea I would have said more stuff for you. I was just chilling.
I just noticed my chat.
Wow, shots fired at yourself.
Yep.
Alright, well, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna keep streaming this? I can raid you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna take a break.
Depends if anything like decent comes up in the next like 10 minutes.
Do you want to dual raid Miltendo? I'm just gonna leave.
Yeah, that's it. Nintendo.
You wanna dual raid him?
Yeah.
Unless you wanna watch more gameplay, that'd be showing gameplay for the next 3 hours.
I'll do with him.
BST, I'll give you his name.
Nintendo, yeah, I actually follow him already.
Oh, you
Nintendo? Ooh, yeah.
Right. So you know how to raid, right? You ever raid before?
Yeah, just hit the halt button, right?
Right. No, /raid and then put his name. Space and then his name.
Yeah. No space.
I'll be back in like 2 hours, 1 hour. I need to take a break. And we'll come back with Fall 76. Battle Royale, probably. I don't know if you play that. But that's what I'm going to do. Fall 76.